Honorable Gabriel Yowal Duke is the deputy co-chair of the South Sudan National Dialogue. Gurtong editor Jacob J. Ecol talked to him last year in Juba and began by asking him if he thought there was will to stop the war.
If this peace, if there is a political will in this country for both stakeholders who are fighting, they should not repeat it. It cannot be repeated because people have expressed their opinion and they don't want any kind of war. They don't want their suffering to continue. And I think that with whatever they are doing in IGAD and revitalization and the national dialogue must come together so that it can meet the aspiration of the people and what they want.
Do you think that the government will accept what the people are looking for?
The government, if the government doesn't even accept, it will be heavy for the government to avoid this demand of the people. Well, that government would really be incredible, highly, if they don't implement what the people are demanding.
Are people united in what they are calling for?
I believe they are united. I'm sure that they are united. Me, I traveled. I went to Khartoum on consultation. I went to Cairo. I went also to Nairobi and even Ethiopia. The same call, the level of demand for peace is there, especially those who are in the neighboring countries, in both refugee camps and also those. A lot of our people are outside. There's no population here.
I know.
I don't think the government can accept this situation anymore.
What would be your message to the people in South Sudan and then to the people in the diaspora, people who are outside the country?
Well, I think the most important is that people will have to forgive one another. The people have to forgive and put this behind. It has happened, it was so damaging, but there's nothing you can do. You must be united again so that you survive yourself and your country. This is our country. Then nobody will be out of it. Everybody, every tribe, community, all of them, their country. So they must forgive one another and create a spirit of unity and people to continue, you see, in their own country. I think this message is very big, taking consideration the way our people in the bordering of these countries, in Ethiopia and Khartoum, Kenya, Uganda, and the diaspora. You see, this we have to fight for peace in a peaceful way.
Well, thank you very much indeed.
Yeah,
thank you.
Thank you. If this peace, if there is a political will in this country for both stakeholders who are fighting, they should not repeat it. It cannot be repeated because people have expressed their opinion and they don't want any kind of war. They don't want their suffering to continue. And I think that with whatever they are doing in IGAD and revitalization and the national dialogue must come together so that it can meet the aspiration of the people and what they want.
Do you think that the government will accept what the people are looking for?
The government, if the government doesn't even accept, it will be heavy for the government to avoid this demand of the people. Well, that government would really be incredible, highly, if they don't implement what the people are demanding.
Are people united in what they are calling for?
I believe they are united. I'm sure that they are united. Me, I traveled. I went to Khartoum on consultation. I went to Cairo. I went also to Nairobi and even Ethiopia. The same call, the level of demand for peace is there, especially those who are in the neighboring countries, in both refugees camps and also those, a lot of our people are outside. There's no population here.
I know.
I don't think the government can accept this situation anymore.
What would be your message to the people in South Sudan and then to the people in the diaspora, people who are outside the country?
Well, I think the most important is that people will have to forgive one another. The people have to forgive and put this behind. It has happened. It was so damaging. But there's nothing you can do. You must be united again so that you survive yourself and your country. This is our country. Then nobody will be out of it. Everybody, every tribe, community, all of them, their country. So they must forgive one another and create a spirit of unity and people to continue. See in their own country. I think this message is very big, taking consideration the way our people in the bordering of these countries, in Ethiopia, and Khartoum, Kenya, Uganda, and the diaspora. You see, this we have to fight for peace in a peaceful way.
Well, thank you very much indeed.
Yeah. Thank you.